Right, thank you very much. Of course, we just are done with the court. We're hoping to proceed in the next sitting. But there are, you know, urgent matters that we want to raise on behalf of the Zambian people. One, first of all, is to advise President Hakainde Hichilema. He is renowned to be Mr. Fixer, one that promised to fix economic challenges and difficulties that the Zambian people are facing. But looking at the continued rise of the minimum prices, which is now going towards 400 kwacha per bag, clearly not even an average or indeed what to do Zambians can afford minimum at that price. We're still to imagine some of our less privileged, the poor people in our society and country that are surviving on hand to mouth. And in the recent past, you notice that this government recklessly got our people out of their business by destroying their makeshift stands that they spent their little resources or capital to put up in place, having been promised that they will be prudent in managing vendors. We have always advised the UPND never to make knee-jerk decisions, especially when it comes to the livelihood of our people. That decision has rendered people not only poor, because they're already poor, but out of business, whilst the cost of minimum is going up. The cost of one bag possibly is twice as much as the capital of most of those people that were selling in the market. But we also have a very critical issue to raise today, is the continuous attempt to interfere with institutions of government by the West, led by America. When there was a crusade of the fight against corruption during Manasa's time, something and things that were unconventional were done. Memorandum of understandings were signed, to which selected magistrates, judges and so on were put on that list to be the ones that would be handling cases specifically identified around Dr. Chirua. That compromised our judiciary. But it looks like that is repeating itself. Zooming from where we stand, some of the statements that are coming from the High Commissioner in their conversations expressing concern that so far those that have been indicted, particularly from Patriotic Front, have not been convicted, and that pressure should be exerted on the judicial system to try and feed into their narrative that they have been selling out there that PF are corrupt. We want to say, let the sacred institution of the Republic of Zambia called the judiciary operate independently without undue pressure. The judiciary must not be pressured by those accused, neither should they be pressured by those who are accusing, worse still, even those who are just spectators and are foreigners. That we don't want to see. Ms. Hakainde Hichilema, Ms. Mtoro Piri, and all those vuvuzelas of UPND, please exert your energies towards fixing the price of minimum than to continue with the propaganda that is targeted towards creating an impression around Patriotic Front. Some of the news items that are circulating from Kosway and others are false, trying to suggest that maybe there is some conflict within Patriotic Front. One of the things that is giving diarrhea to UPND is that they were hoping that PF would be divided by now, but we remain strong and united, and Aluta Continua will continue being united. Thank you very much.